Dear all, it's an honor to be invited to present our best practices in sustainable mobility during the International Workshop Greenmetric. My name is Erna Maters, and as a policy person on social responsibility, I work together with Joke Luttig, our overall sustainability coordinator, on the sustainability policies of Wageningen University and Research. If I would send you a postcard from the Netherlands, it could well be this one, with a nice cloudy sky, a canal, a windmill and tulip fields. The Netherlands is a small country in Europe, quite densely populated with 70 million people. And it is really flat over here. For mobility, being flat and small has some advantages. We do not need to fly from one part of the country to the other. We can maintain a good network of highways and railroads. We can transport people and goods over water. And it is very easy to cycle. And that's what we do a lot in the Netherlands, cycling. In total, the Dutch own 23 million bicycles. Every household has on average 3 bikes. Let me show you Wageningen campus. This picture gives an overview of the campus. It has a green area with big buildings in the middle. Buildings Orion and Forum are entirely for education, including the library and laboratories. University departments and research units are located in the lower buildings on the right side. Far right, you see the greenhouses and the fields of Unifarm, and that's the university farm. Wageningen University and Research is a partnership of two organizations, Wageningen University and Wageningen Research. Parts of both organizations work together in education, research and value creation. Wageningen University does education and fundamental research and is located in Wageningen. Wageningen Research does more applied research aimed at life sciences and has several locations. WERS ambition on social responsibility is stated in our strategic plan and is in line with the mission. To explore the potential of nature to improve the quality of life. Keywords are vitality and health, sustainable and healthy food, reducing food waste, circularity, and social responsible procurement. Since 2016, WERS broadened its sustainability policy to corporate social responsibility, CSR in short. Since then, we are working with a CSR agenda. The current agenda contains 17 themes that are important for our internal and external stakeholders. The themes are roughly split in two. Some are connected to research and education. Others are more linked to our operations and do cover governance, human resources, and care for the environment. The CSR themes can be linked to several sustainable development goals. Sustainable mobility is one of the CSR themes and is linked to SDG 13. Climate action. Mobility is an essential component of sustainable operational management at WERS. We aim at transport modes with lower emissions. On campus, this is visible. There's a special bus line for public transport. We do have facilities for bicycles and charging points for electric cars and bikes. However, between 2010 and 2020, there has been a clear increase in travel at WERS. In particular, in the number of kilometers traveled by aeroplane and motor vehicles. To tackle the increased negative impact of all travel, WERS adopted in 2019 a renewed long-term policy on sustainable mobility, the Mobility Plan 2030, with an associated implementation agenda. This policy focuses on sustainable transport options such as cycling and public transport, discouraging travel by car or air, and making transport more sustainable. A mobility plan focuses on reducing transport movements and encourage more sustainable transport. The ambition is to reduce carbon emissions from mobility by 2% annually. The focus is on encouraging our staff and students to cycle even more. We do encourage the use of public transport and discourage travel with vehicles on fossil fuels, and we do facilitate alternatives to car and air travel. Part of the implementation agenda include encouraging the use of public transport for business travel within the Netherlands and to nearby destinations in Europe. Facilitating and encouraging the use of video conference options and promoting commuting by bicycle and using electric vehicles. I will tell you more about three examples of projects that we are working on. At least 50% of all Wehr employees do commute by bike. As there is still room for improvement, several measures have been taken. Wehr has a bicycle scheme that gives staff the opportunity to buy a private bicycle with tax benefit. The scheme was recently adapted. The term increased from 3 to 5 years to make it possible to spend an amount of 2,500 euros. This makes it easier for staff to buy an electric bicycle suitable for longer distances. The project E-Bike to Work gave employees the opportunity to try out an e-bike or speed pedelec for 2 weeks for their commute to work. This project is targeted at employees that live within a 7.5-40 km radius. Approximately 150 employees joined. Some of them bought an e-bike or speed pedelec afterwards. Recently, we improved the bicycle parking facilities on campus by replacing outdated bicycle racks. Also, more space has been created for special bicycles such as cargo bikes and electric bicycles. In March of this year, Wehr introduced mobility as a service on campus. It offers shared mobility services based on sustainability criteria from the mobility plan. MaaS enables employees to make use of an integrated, convenient, innovative and sustainable transport concept. The first phase is implemented. The first electric shared cars are available at hubs with charging points. The second step is to create bicycle hubs. Later on, public transport options will be added to the app. And also the target groups will also be expanded to include students and other users. For air travel, we did launch a new policy on business travel within Europe, with a guideline when to use what mode of transport. Goal is to restrict air travel. Public transport will be required for destinations that can be reached by train within 8 hours. We cannot give yet an insight on the effect of the stricter policy as it went into effect on March 1, 2020. 2 weeks later, the COVID-19 pandemic reached the Netherlands and that limited air travel. In the Wehr Travel Check, travel destinations that can be reached within 8 hours are mapped out. The map will be updated regularly. As train trajectories change over time, cities might be more easily reached by train in future. As I mentioned, Wehr's ambition is to reduce greenhouse gas emissions of all Wehr transport by at least 2% annually. Reference year is 2017. So at this moment, our target for carbon emission in 2030 is 14 kiloton CO2 equivalents. The figure above shows our total carbon footprint for the main emission sources in the past years. The blue bars indicate the greenhouse gas emissions from mobility. As you can see, these emissions increased to 20 kiloton on average, covering 47% of the total footprint. In the second figure, we mapped out our target emissions. Less travel in 2020-2021 due to the COVID-19 pandemic halved our carbon emissions from transport as indicated with the blue dot. The footprint of 2019 did have a total of 41.2 kiloton CO2. In the 2020 footprint, you can see the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. The total was 30.6 kiloton CO2, 26% less. Main cause for this drop were the travel restrictions, especially in air travel, and the daily commute of staff. COVID-19 accelerated many changes in working patterns. During the pandemic, new working arrangements were developed. Two examples are virtual meetings and e-conferences, and remote or hybrid working. These other arrangements do have advantages. Less time is needed for traveling, you'll have less travel expenses, and the environmental impact is lower. Meeting virtually means also that you have more options to engage others, and this makes it also more inclusive for those who are unable to travel. Working from home or elsewhere also made it possible to improve work-life balance and thus reduce the need for office space. Over the years, Wuhr has taken various steps to lower the environmental impact of travel. The mobility plan was implemented to bring our sustainable mobility policy to a higher level. Since 2019, various actions were carried out to encourage the use of public transport and bicycles, to discourage car use, to facilitate alternatives to air travel, and to make the various transport options more sustainable. The COVID-19 pandemic had a large impact on travel patterns. It is impossible to tell yet whether these changes in working and traveling will be permanent. The challenge is to put the new experiences into practice. We expect that the new working and travel patterns will continue, at least to some extent. One example is that employees are expected to work from home for 2 days a week on average, as opposed to 1 day a week before the pandemic. We will also promote virtual meetings, e-conferences, and forms of remote and/or hybrid working. We will continue to monitor the results and impacts of the various sustainable mobility measures and will adapt, refine, and renew the set of measures for better results and more impact in future. For our carbon emission target, a reduction in air travel is where the biggest challenge lies. It will be difficult to reach this target as we do not fly if we do not fly less. But international travel is inseparable from a university and research organization such as Wuhr. I could have told you a lot more, but time is up. Our mobility policy can be found in our website or in the paper we wrote for this Green Metric International Workshop. Thank you for your attention.